This is for bit, huh? True story. Let's go. It's crazy how your childhood can be taken away. He was a young boy, but a ruthless killer the next day. No one saw it coming, it was a sunny day. Birds chirping, hummingbirds humming, but that all once changed. The big cloud came, he could feel the little drops of rain as the ground shook and the tanks came. He ran into the house hearing his mother scream his name. The rest of it is fuzzy, it might have been the fear that made it unclear, or the picture of his father getting shot that he couldn't bear. That day his father and brothers became martyrs. With slight luck he managed just to escape, but wondering why God gave him this fate. Worst part of it was on his birthday. Yeah, the cake was made, but while in the raid, it fell to the ground and his 18 candles blew out. From that point on, all he knew was hate. Broken heart, didn't bother trying to fix it. Full of anger and revenge, he enlisted. They gave him a uniform, beret to the side tilted. The AK feeling a bit heavy, but he won't admit it. From that point on, it was all firefights and sleepless nights. After a full year of war, he was a kid no more. Used to have red cheeks, innocent eyes. That was gone and replaced by the instinct to survive. When 19 years of age, filled with rage, he led the team in every raid. And that AK that once felt so heavy, he's carrying that with one more on his back. Folded stock, double mag, to him that's all he had. It was winter and he was on stakeout. Had his AK on his lap and he was all dazed out. Had his father in his mind a few days now. Couldn't get him out of his head, thinking of every word he ever said. Be a man, weakness and pain never show. Never ask for no handouts, always carry your own. As a teardrop started to get larger, he grasped the cold barrel of the AK even harder. He's been having dreams about his fathers that he's saying he couldn't be any more prouder. Not to worry about his brothers, they're all fine. To go and recite the fatia at his grave sometime. As he hears someone coming, he wipes his tears as they were running. He has him in his sights, squeezes the trigger. He empties a full mag but couldn't release his finger. 3 years have passed and the war ends at last. Everything's changed, peace found, amends made. But the struggles did not end there. He knew he had no home to return to. He roamed on his own trying to find a place to go home. Carrying a bag full of medals, but still fighting his own devils. Still filled with hatred and fear, his AK was always still near. Now living on a day-to-day basis, constantly being haunted by all the death faces. But trying to put everything behind him and trying to erase it.